see what I did there? Did you know what that looked like? It looked like a parabola. Now, you may wonder, what the heck is a parabola? Well, I will let my assistants explain some of them to you.
Parabola is the graph of a quadratic function y equals ax squared plus bx plus c. Parabola. If a is greater than 0, then the parabola opens upward and has a minimum point. But if a is less than 0, then the parabola opens downward and has a maximum point.
Now, let's find the vertex and the axis of symmetry of the quadratic function. But before that, what exactly is a quadratic function? Now, quadratic function. It is a function that can be written in ax squared plus bx plus c, where a, b, and c are real numbers. And a is not equal to 0. The highest exponent variable is 2. Hence, it is called the second degree function.
In graph of the quadratic function, draw the graph of a quadratic function y equals x squared minus 2x minus 3. First is to find the vertex and the line of symmetry of y equals x squared minus 2x minus 3 by expressing the function in the form of y equals a times the quantity of x minus h squared plus k. But before finding the vertex and the line of symmetry of y equals x squared minus 2x minus 3, is that we have to follow these steps. First is to group the terms containing x. Then step 2 is to factor out the variable a. If a equals 1, then proceed to step 3. Step 3 is to complete the expression in the parentheses to make it a perfect square trinomial, by adding the quantity of b over 2 squared and then subtracting a times the quantity of b over 2 squared to the constant term. Simplify the and express the perfect square trinomial as the square of a binomial. Now, step 1, y equals x squared minus 2x minus 3. Then, moving on, y equals the quantity of x squared minus 2x minus 3, since it says in the step 1 is to group the terms containing x, which is the x squared minus 2x. Then step 2 is to factor out the variable a. Since a is equals to 1, then we will only proceed to step 3 now, which is adding quantity of b over 2 squared, where the value of our b is negative 2, which is the negative 2x inside the parentheses. Now, negative 2 over 2 squared, it can be simplified and divide by 2, which is its denominator, then the answer will be negative 1 times negative 1 again, since it says here negative 1 squared. Then the answer will be positive 1. Then next is by subtracting a times the quantity of b over 2 squared. Now, since we have got our b over 2 squared, we will just copy the answer 1. Then the value of our a, which is 1, so 1 times 1 equals 1. Then we will add 3 minus 1, since it's both negative, negative 3, negative 1, the answer will be negative 4. Then, saan nga natin nakuha ang x minus 1 squared? Since our b over 2 squared ay kinalabasan ay negative 1, and yun ang square of binomial natin, so kinopya lang natin ang x kay 2 na mayroon squared, so, magiging quantity of x, tinanggal natin yung squared niya, then minus, kinuha natin, b over 2 squared, na ang kinalabasan ay negative 1, nang dinivide siya by 2 sa negative 2 over 2, yon kinalabasan then is negative 1, so yun ang square of binomial natin, negative 1 squared, then copy, minus 4. So, the value of our a is 1, the value of our h is 1, positive 1, correctly, since magbabago rin yan, pag positive 1 yung h natin, vice versa, magiging negative 1 ang magiging value niya. Then, our k, just copy, negative 4. Sa vertex natin, nalalaman natin, h and k, so value of our h is 1, then value of our k is negative 4. Then, axis of symmetry, the formula is x equals h, well, our h, the value of our h is 1, so copy na. Now, moving on to constructing the table of values. So, saan nga natin nakuha ang 1 and negative 4? Diba, ang sagot natin is h natin is 1, which is yung x, magiging x, and our y is negative 4, which is yung k. Now, moving on to constructing the table of values. Values of x is negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, may nawawala sa y, which is isa lang ang meron, is negative 4. So, the problem below, you can see na gagamitin natin ang y equals the quantity of x minus 1 squared minus 4 na ang ating sagot kanina sa paghahanap kay vertex and axis of symmetry. Now, just by copying it, isa-substitute natin ang value ni x, yung negative 2, kaya naging quantity of negative 2 minus 1 squared minus 4. So, by doing the FOIL method, ang kinalabasan niyan ay magiging y equals 9, then bring down lang natin yung 4, negative 4 minus 9, ang sagot niyan ay magiging 5. Then, same process na rin sa iba. Yun yun ang gagawin. Substitute the value of x. Then, do the FOIL method. Kasi squared nga siya. Then, if nakuha na ang answer sa FOIL method, tulad ng negative 2 minus 1 squared, which is yung answer niya ay 9, ima-minus siya kay 4, and kinalabasan niya ay magiging y equals 5. Tulad din sa ibang equation, negative 1 minus 1 squared, do the FOIL method, then ang magiging answer is 4, then minus it by 4, then the answer of your y will be 0. Then do the rest to others.
After we construct a table of values, mag-graph naman tayo. Using the table of values na nakuha natin, we can now plot its points sa Cartesian plane. So, ang unahin natin i-plot ay ang negative 2 and 5. So, dito siya mabibilang sa quadrant 2. Next is negative 1 and 0. Dito siya nakaplot dahil yung x natin is negative 1 and yung y natin is 0. Sunod ay ang 0 and negative 3. Ang x natin naman dito ay 0 at ang y natin dito ay negative 3. So, dito siya nakaplot. Sunod is 1 and negative 4. Dito siya nakaplot sa quadrant 4. Ang x natin ay 1 and y natin is negative 4. Next naman ay 2 and negative 3. Dito din siya nakaplot sa quadrant 4. Sunod is 3 and 0. Yung x natin is 3. So, dito siya nakaplot and yung y natin ay 0. Dito sila nakaplot. And last one is 4 and 5. Yung x natin ay 4 at ang y natin ay 5. So dito sila naka-plotch, which is sa quadrant 1. And pagkatapos natin ma-plot lahat, ang gagawin naman natin ay i-connect natin yung mga points by smooth curve. So ganyan yung graph ni y equals quantity of x minus 1 squared minus 4. So since positive yung value ng a natin, kaya yung itsura ng opening ng nabuong graph natin is upward. Now, you have the graph of quadratic function.
Ikiru no wa iyada.